What is the human's dharma towards the animals? No one would like to be killed. Love them. Feed them. Don't eat them. It is said in Vedas, also in our Puranas, and now it's also, it is found it in Bible or in Old Testaments. Those who have eyes, don't eat them. If I am a real Christian, I will follow. I consider myself in this way a real Christian. I am. Not the people who live in the Christian world. And that was said, ahimsa parmo dharma, thou shall not kill. Non-violence, physical, mental, spiritual, social, political, intellectual, so on. Violence is opposite to the ethic. Therefore, the spirituality is lost due to some mistakes, conflict in certain religious groups. Some are disappointed and try to root it out all the spiritual principles. That was a great mistake. A human doesn't have a spiritual education. That human has no any direction, is a lost without direction. The one speaker, the Petra, who was the last one, both sisters, Petra or Mikhaila? Mikhaila. She spoke very true things, very truth. And that's what I'm facing. The grown children, 20 years, 15 years, 25 years, 30 years, they tell exactly the problem which she mentioned and how to help them. We try. But you know, when you are bitten once by a snake and someone brings that, said, this is a beautiful cobra, he will not bite you. But still, we said, no, thank you. He said, no, it will not bite, take it. Look how beautiful. It's, yes, it's okay, thank you. Or a dog. I remember once a dog was biting me. I have 5 centimeter scar on my thigh still. Doesn't matter how good dog is, my heartbeat goes high. Even good dog, I will love that dog and touch, fetch that dog. But my heart is beating, you can, my pulse rate will be very high, the heart rate. Because I experienced. And that fear, that experience which is in subconsciousness, is very hard to get rid of it. We will forgive it, but we will not forget it. In India we say, when the dog bites you, when a dog bites you, you cannot bite back. But you will tell yourself in future, have a safety distance. Similarly, frustrated youth, what they call the gangs, in different ways, groups, drugs, alcohols, and many other things. Look at the background of the parents. I heard even after 15 years or something, 14 years, 10 years, parents, when the child goes to school, they before sell the house and they go away. Children don't know where it is because they don't want. I was in Los Angeles having a lecture in the gangs club. Can you imagine me going in the gangs club? I said, my car must have a bulletproof glass. And then they took me through, and they were sitting the guy, they were looking. I said, hello. No answer. Now, there were about 40 boys and girls, very strong, with many, many signs, sitting in one room. Place was not enough chairs, standing near the windows. And organizers, three were with me. One of my disciples from Europe was with, like a bodybuilder, he wanted to protect me, but I said, well, I trust my destiny. When I decided to do something, and I spoke 40 minutes, and you will not believe me, out of 42 or 44 people, 25 had tears in their eyes. They were so gentle, they were so soft. And then was the questions. And one boy was sitting with one leg on the table, other hand somewhere. And then he said, I think you are a good guy. And when I went out of that club, you can't imagine how someone wanted to hug me and kiss me. And of course, I had to play with them, you know. So these children or this youth needs understanding and love. So they didn't get this from the parents. They had a bad experiences in the school time. If we will have a spiritual education, prayers, universal prayers, maybe you don't like towards one particular religion, but spirituality is the way, path for a human to get a perfection and follow the human dharma. If we will follow the human dharma is not a fighting. Humans are a protector, not a distractor. Human itself is a model, the form, the messenger, the incarnation of the ethic and moral values. Our children doesn't need education, but the parents needs education. We have to teach the parents, the young generations, who is going to be the father or mother. Many thousands of disciples, I don't know how many thousands in Czech Republic, meanwhile, yoga in daily life is practiced more than 2 million people in last 38 years I'm coming. When they get married, they ask me, Swamiji, bless, and I, of course, do bless them. But sometime when they get divorced, I'm unhappy. Because they know the society, how it's functioning, and especially the medias. Medias are very good, but medias can be also damaging many things. And in media, since the greed appeared, advertising, giving money in advertising, attracting our attention, that was harmful in media. Otherwise, the media is great things. So we need tolerance in religions. On the name of the religion, many wars were fighted and many humans were divided. We need understanding for every single person and every country. We must have respect to every culture and learn to love, not to hate. Doesn't matter which skin color we have, but we have one common. We all have a red blood. We all have five elements, and we have all one soul in our body, except pregnant woman. She has two souls. And you know, the psychic damage on child begins on the first day when the mother and father, or male or him and female, comes together. In which condition she was, and in which condition he was. Was he alcoholic, drunken, angry, aggressive? What situation was that? And that affects the child's development and the future life. And especially, again, during the pregnancy, what was the behavior of the man, the father? I heard that many times when woman is pregnant, the man then goes to the clubs, comes late at home, she's sitting alone. Especially when woman is pregnant, then dharma of the man to be all the times there. You see in the nature also, monkeys or the tigers or the lions and all, how gentle, even the birds, how gentle they are with the mothers. But we human lost this sense. And therefore ethic values, we do have still in our shastras. We shall now bring again to the people. We tried everything. We learned everything. Too much our children are learning in school, and what they are learning today, and when they will become doctor, professor, they will not use this knowledge because this is already old. Every day new technology coming. Therefore yoga is ancient wisdom for the modern man, for the modern time. That is everlasting wisdom. Yoga makes us real human. And to realize our aims, the self-realization and spirituality. So, we tried everything. Now we have to go back. So one philosopher said, we learned how to swim like a fish, and we learned how to fly like an aeroplane. But now we have to live like a human. That we have to learn. So thank you very much for this beautiful time and beautiful thoughts from everyone. I learned a lot. Always we can learn. Wisdom has no end. I do hope that we got a wonderful and valuable lessons here, wisdom. And it's not only that I told and you heard. We shall utilize this, spread further. So thank you once more. And God bless you. God bless this country. And God bless the whole world, that human gets right message, that we again begin with the spiritual education, love, protect, care, understand, and don't fight. Thank you very much. Bless you. We begin in India always with mantra, ending with the mantra. Mantra brings good energy, purifies the energy. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kachya Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shantir Bhavatu. My Grand Master Bhagwan Deep Narayan Mahaprabhuji, always used to say, love each and every entity, if not more than it must, that much as you love yourself. So if we will love everyone, as Mahaprabhuji said, there will be no any more troubles. Hari Om. Dobro kush.